Hi, I'm Dr. Colin Campbell, and this is a Meter Chalk Talk. Have you ever been outside on a hot day walking in the full sun and then stepped into the shade? The relief is almost immediate. And I was thinking about that a lot when I was looking at this graph here, the estimated crop water loss on one of my experiments. So this is an ET0, meaning a reference ET, but since I was working in grass, that was actually the estimated water loss from this grass crop. And what I noticed was that the shape of this curve kind of went up and then went down, and it kind of matched right here the solstice, the summer solstice. And in my mind, I thought, you know, what impact does direct solar radiation have on the overall radiation balance? Well, we can quickly just jump down and look at the equation that talks about how we might estimate the evapotranspiration from a crop. I'm not going to be able to have time here to get into what each of these variables mean, but as you see, solar absorbed radiation, or ABS, is a strong component of that overall calculation. Now, when we talk about absorbed radiation, we need to understand that it's not just all direct sunlight. In fact, if you assume that, you'd be off in the weeds quite a bit, because it contains components of both long wave radiation, which is radiation that's coming from your terrestrial surroundings, and short wave radiation, that which is coming from predominantly the sun. So let's talk about that for a minute. So with absorbed radiation, we have shortwave radiation. This is radiation that's less than 4 micrometers. And we have longwave radiation. This is, not surprisingly, from wavelengths greater than 4 micrometers. Now, this shortwave radiation, this comes from the sun. Longwave radiation comes from other sources, like trees, the sky, the ground, just other objects that are around the temperature that we expect in the natural environment. Now, the truth of the matter is, to get our ABS, we need to combine both of these things into a single number. And it actually gets even more complex than that. So bear with us as we go on to the next equation. So our ABS is a function of both shortwave radiation and longwave radiation. And when we calculate our radiation balance to get absorbed radiation, we have to actually take all of this into account. Now, you might be wondering, what are the other pieces in this equation? We're going to spend a little time going over that so you might understand how we can get from all of these numbers, all of these potential sources of radiation, to a final number of RF. This portion of the equation here is shortwave radiation. And we're going to talk about the variables in that equation. The first one we see is alpha S. It's a number between 0 and 1. It signifies the percentage of shortwave radiation that the object can absorb. The other parameters in the equation include some Fs and some Ss. The Fs we call view factors. We'll discuss view factors in more detail in another Chalk Talk, but suffice it to say that these essentially are parameters that estimate the amount of radiation that our object can see in its surroundings. S stands for shortwave radiation, and this comes from several different sources. They include P. This is radiation that's coming directly from the sun. That's the one I mentioned earlier that we feel if we're standing in the direct sun versus if we walk into the shade. But there are a couple of others. One is diffuse. This is the radiation that's scattered as light comes into our atmosphere, and it's scattered by the atmosphere. Finally, there's R. This is reflected radiation. Radiation that when it comes and hits a surface, it reflects off that surface and comes and impinges on our object. Think about snow. If you've ever been skiing or out on the snow, you know on a sunny day, you're getting a lot of radiation that's being reflected back. This portion of the equation over here is our long wave portion. Similar to our short wave, it contains many of the same symbols, but they're a little bit different. The alpha L is the absorbed radiation now in the long wave that also goes from 0 to 1. The F is our view factor again, but now the view factor of long wave radiation, and L stands for that long wave radiation. This time, the subscripts A, that stands for atmosphere, and G stands for ground. If we put together all components in this equation, we'll be able to solve for absorbed radiation, but that's going to take a little bit of work. First, we need to understand the absorptivity of our surface, both in the short wave and the long wave. The short wave typically is calculated just from tables or looking out on the internet. For example, if I wanted to look at the absorptivity of a maple leaf, that's typically around 50%, but something that's probably been calculated in literature. For our long wave radiation, almost all objects absorb long wave radiation at about 97 to 98% of the possible total. So it's pretty easy to estimate these absorptivities for objects that are fairly common. Calculating solar radiation and long wave radiation take a little bit more time, and especially understanding the view factors or how much of a particular surface our object sees is going to take a whole chalk talk on its own. We're going to leave this discussion here and leave for next time an opportunity to talk about how to calculate our shortwave radiation, our longwave radiation, and then get to the complicated discussion of view factors. For more content like this, head over to our YouTube channel or go to metergroup.com. Thanks for watching Meter Chalk Talks.